Hello Arnold, welcome to the show. Thank you Arnold for the invitation. Arnold, I'd like to discuss a subject right now that's been gripping my heart. What is it, Arnold? Arnold, I'd like to discuss happiness and well-being. What do you want to talk about, Arnold? I'd like to hear your thoughts. Well, Arnold, it's very hard to begin somewhere. Happiness has been defined over the ages as a very broad and differing topic, depending on the context of the culture and also the person talking about it. It's hard to define happiness, which, without a proper and clear definition, immediately makes me think of happiness chasing neo-Buddhism has brought to the West. Interesting opening, Arnold. Can you elaborate on the happiness chasing? Well, I'm speaking from a West European perspective here and there. Many people who adopt neo-Buddhist beliefs. You see Buddha statues in people's homes and a lot of ideas combined with neoliberalism that happiness is makeable and the end goal, which really makes you think, because obviously there's still a lot of suffering in the world. I think it's naive just to be concerned to be happy. But Arnold, don't we all deserve to be happy? Well, I wish people happiness, but I think it's impossible to state that everyone can be happy all the time. Why not be sad? Why not be anxious? These are bad feelings, but they make you human and more in touch with who you really are. Pretending someone you're not, does that make you more happy? I think we're using the wrong terminology. What do you mean, Arnold? Let's talk about Stoicism, not the one that Marcus Aurelius is blabbering about. But the real original gangster Epictetus shit. Stoicism is another trending topic to be able to deal with the harsh realities of the world, in that aspect, similar to assertism. As Wikipedia states, Epictetus taught that philosophy is a way of life and not just a theoretical discipline. To Epictetus, all external events are beyond our control. We should accept calmly and dispassionately whatever happens. However, individuals are responsible for their own actions, which they can examine and control through rigorous self-discipline. But Arnold, what about being the change you want to see in the world around you? If you look at the amount of people that have really accomplished that, it's quite a rare event, which we don't understand. This is proven to be dependent on something other than luck. Is it worth devoting your life to trying to change the world to achieve this? Should that be our duty? I don't think so. The locus of control within your vicinity is much more important to be able to fully control your life and be in touch with your inner self. I don't see how this has to do with happiness chasing. I think we started misinterpreting things along the way. Be happy. Work on your dreams. You can be anything. I think these are all false and toxic statements. While an individual with stoicism as perspective has a lot of effect on our own choices to be more content in life, I think that's a better goal than happiness. There's just a lot of hard proof that this way society handles a person also influences their choices. Why can't we just state that it's a delicate combination of both responsibilities and therefore statements as be happy or work on your dreams or you can be anything can be deemed false, perhaps even toxic in a certain individual situation? Ja.